Jackson students, staff, and faculty members.
And welcome to the $30
The featured story is on Purple Out Basketball Game.
They came out with
and enjoy the rest of the day at Cedar Point, America's Rock and Roller Coaster. Ride on.
Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh!
No
my heart
way!
Oh my
gosh!
Oh my gosh! He's right there! Oh my
Can you please follow me back? Can you teach me how to dab?
I'm gonna show you how to.
Girls play on the 18th, Thursday, February 18th.
February 19th.
February 19th, the boys play. At halftime, we walk in memory or in honor of someone who has died of cancer.
JV starts at 5:30 and varsity follows, and we play to raise money for cancer survivors and support them.
We play Vandercook.
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 We're going to play Michigan Center.
We play Michigan Center.
The Purple Out is special because it's not a pink out, so it's not just breast cancer. So now it's all cancer, so now we can play in honor and in memory of all our loved ones.
Because we're about to ball up, break some ankles, and win this for cancer.
This game is special because we walk in honor and memory of those with cancer and other illnesses. East Jackson always does a great job with this cause. I'd like to thank Kelly Blau and all those that help her with this cause in this game to bring the awareness out to the public.
So we're excited about the Purple Out game for the girls and the boys. It's February 18th and 19th. It used to be called the Pink Out game, but the color purple represents all forms of cancer. So I think it's important, it's a great cause, and it brings the community together on those two nights. So we're excited.
When were you diagnosed with cancer?
July 10, 2010. I had breast cancer. They thought I had it on both sides, so they recommended a bilateral mastectomy because if I didn't have it, there was a 50% chance that it would come back within a year. So I talked to my girls and we voted on doing it. So
how long was your process?
When I first found out, they were going to make me wait 6 weeks to 3 months to have the surgery, but when you hear the word cancer, you kind of freak out.
Yeah.
So they did it within 2 weeks. I did an overnight in the hospital. I should have stayed at least a couple of nights. It was kind of hard when I got home. I was lucky in the respect that even though I had to have a bilateral mastectomy, I didn't have to have chemotherapy and radiation because of that.
That's good. What would you tell people who are battling now?
To keep family close and be positive.
I would tell them that chemo sucks.
How did you support your wife when she was battling cancer?
Well, I went to every one of her chemotherapies when she was going through that at the hospital. And basically whatever she needed, I was there for. She couldn't get comfortable sometimes with the bed that we had, the couch we had, so we went out and bought new things to make her as comfortable as possible, but it was just a constant trying to stay positive with whatever she needed. There were a lot of times that I had to cook, which I like to cook anyway, but I had to cook our meals for the night or for the day when she was going through what she was going through. And so yeah, it was a trying time, but everything is going very well.
Here are the results. Do you ever feel like a plastic bag? So it seems like both of you feel like a plastic bag. I think that's pretty cool. On to the next one.
And for track or whatever other sports that you want to do, so they can get stronger, quicker, faster, or whatever sports they're playing. We're getting around 20 right now. Most of the kids are going to play winter sports. They're down here lifting. Ideally, even when you're playing a sport, you should get to 20 tables. We have a weight lifting regimen. We track everybody's weights and how they do and how they progress, so that by the time fall time comes, they should increase their bench press and squat by hopefully about 50 pounds.
I just want to be as strong as I can be for the next football season. It's my last year.
Looking out for the off season to improve my strength so I can become an all-conference football player again.
If a stranger walked up to you and asked you to donate money for cancer, would you give them money? If so, how much?
If it was a stranger, I would probably not give them money unless they had something official from a nonprofit organization or the American Cancer Society. I did have some neighbor girls come by with something from their school asking for money to help cure cancer, and I donated, I gave them $5. How come we don't say I love you
enough till it's too late? What team do you want to win the 2016 Super Bowl?
I want the Denver Broncos to win. Broncos all the way.
Do you know why the universal color for cancer is now purple?
I believe the universal color of purple represents all cancer.
Magic Bird and Bernard Kane. And number 33, my man Kareem is the center on my stoning team.
Trojans are on the field. All might and main.
Too bad for
Manchester High, cause
we're here to win this game.
So take that ball along and keep it high.
Lost T's and crossing I's and dotted. I fought it a lot, and it seems a lot like.